join.
Today we are so happy to talk about a quite important matter. Nowadays, so many people are afraid of English, they say.
It's so difficult. I don't know many English words. I need something in my native language and translate into English.
You speak with a lot of pauses and hesitation, but you want to speak English fluently and naturally like a native English speaker. The secret is learn to love English.
How to love English?
Well, when we make friends with English, we can consider it as a part in our life to familiar with it. Let's think about and use it every day.
However, speaking as native language isn't easy. If you think in the native language and generate reason in sentences that don't sound natural in English, because the sentence structure is often different in English and native language.
In addition, it takes too much time to think and translate when you are in a conversation, leading to pause, hesitation, and inability to speak fast fluently. Here are some pieces of advice. Number one, thinking in individual English words. For example, when you wake up in the morning, you can think about toothbrush, bedroom, breakfast, clothes, shoe, or when you study, you can think about pen, book, paper, desk, eraser, or even when you go to work, you can think of computer, job, boss, or sometimes you can play an interesting game with your friends, such as I'm going to speak out loud. It's what you must tell the first thing that comes to your mind. Is that clear? For example, if I say grass, you can tell green, beautiful, or anything else you think of. Let's go. Let's start English.
Funny, important, not easy.
Family.
Father, mother, and my brother.
Tell us sweet.
Beautiful, single, tall.
And people?
Nice, intelligent, lazy.
Is it easy?
Yes. Level 2, thinking in complete English sentence. On this level, you think in complete sentence during the day. When you are at lunch, you can think, I'm eating a sandwich. My friend is drinking soda. Or you are watching TV, you can think, that actually is so handsome. This film is interesting. It's okay if the sentences are very simple. The most important part is to practice and develop the habit of thinking complete sentences. Why don't we play the same over?
Yes!
But last time, we will use a sentence but not a word.
Yes.
What do you like?
Oh, I like eating, hanging out with family, friends, and I like studying English.
Mm-hmm. Why do you love English?
Because it helped me raise my knowledge about the world and helped me be more confident to communicate with friends. Level 3, functional English. On this level, you imagine that you use English for everything that you need to do. For example, how would you order a drink or ask way in English speaking country? You can say, could I have a lemonade? No sugar? Or, excuse me, can you tell me how to get to somewhere? This has developed your English for real life situation. And during the exercise, if you don't know how to say something, check your dictionary later.
Level 4, narrative English. Telling a story or speaking in English for a long time is the best way to do this exercise when you have time. when you are waiting somebody or taking public transportation, think of memory or story that you would like to an English speaking friend. For example, this afternoon I go to Eagle with my friend to make this video. It takes too much time for us to finish. Although we have difficulty in producing, we try to make best video possible.
We hope that the tip will make you more confident and have you speak English easily.
You can start right now.
Thank you for watching.